Hi, welcome to IoT tutorial from Robojax. In this video, we are going to use the Sun Founders ESP32 with ESP32 extension board to use DHT11 or DHT22 to measure the temperature and humidity on your mobile device or on the browser. Let's get started with this. ESP32 starter kit from Sun Founder. This is the best ESP32 learning kit from Sun Founder. It has this ESP32 microcontroller, which has built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. This board can do everything Arduino Uno can do or many other Arduinos can do, plus extra more features. Because we have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, the possibilities are endless. You can get connected to the cloud or do the control or read information or values via your mobile device or your desktop or over the cloud from a far location. It comes with a camera extension kit where you can stream the video over Wi-Fi either through the cloud or to your network. And also it comes with micro SD card where you can save images on the micro SD cards, or you can write from the device any information, log the information on the device and read it back. You can power the board using this included 18650 lithium battery, and it has built-in charger where you can connect micro USB and charge the battery. The kit comes with 320 pieces of component that you can learn tons of projects. This is an Internet of Things. When the device connected to the internet and provide information or being controlled over the internet, they are called Internet of Things. And this is Internet of Things tutorial. I've already learned how to use DHT temperature sensor with ESP32 and ESP32 extension board. The link for that video is below this video if you haven't seen it. In that video, we learned also how to install the library, which I'm not going to repeat it here. Please watch that video so you can install the library. But in this video, we are going to use the Wi-Fi feature of ESP32. And now this is acting as a web server and it has an IP address, and we are using our mobile device or a browser. We can access the IP address and read the temperature from via this ESP32. So the temperature is measured here, and this is propagating it via Wi-Fi, and we have been connected to the same network and we are reading it. And here also, this is connected to the same network as this one. So this is the most critical part. When we connect this to your router, whatever its ID is, this phone must be connected to the same router, otherwise you will not be able to see it. And if you get out of your house or building, then you cannot measure it. For that, you need a separate solution so you can find out the IP address. I assume that you already have prepared and downloaded all the required software that I mentioned it in lesson one. If you have not watched it, please watch that video. And also, if you have not watched that DHT temperature sensor video or tutorial, please watch it so you learn how to install the library for this. Otherwise, this will not work. Come to this page, docs.sunfounder.com. Scroll down until you see ESP32. Then click on ESP32 Starter Kit Main. On the left side, click on Arduino User. I've started this code from the example that is located in files, example, and then under the ESP32, just scroll down until you see web server and advanced web server. This was the code that I have initially started it and modified it for our purpose. I will provide you this code. We are defining a refresh value, how fast the information is being updated. 3 seconds is still very fast. It should be at least 10 seconds of type integer and constant, and then show serial. If you set this to false, it will not display any information here. Let me open the serial monitor. You see it shows the temperature, and if I close it, we don't need it at the moment. So you can set this to false if you don't need it. And here, this is a unit. If you want Celsius, just type 0. And if you want Fahrenheit, type 1. So this is for that purpose. And these are the texts for, this is the temperature title for Celsius, the temperature title for Fahrenheit, and the humidity title. If you speak other than English, you can type your text here. Make sure to respect this double quotation, and your text should not include double quotation. Or the unit for Celsius, Fahrenheit, and percent, do not change this. This is including the DHT library. This is the pen that is used by DHT library, which is pin 14, and this is DHT 11. If you want to use DHT 22, just change this to DHT 22, or comment this line like this, and uncomment this line, and it will work for DHT 22. Now, from the library of DHT, we create an object called DHT with the lower D, H, and T, and we are passing the pin and the type. And these are the variables that are holding temperature value, temperature F value, which is Fahrenheit, and humidity value. Please do. These are the code needed for the ESP32 to work as a Wi-Fi client, web server, and MDNS, ESP MDNS. Do not change them. Type your SSID for your Wi-Fi, for example, like that, and then type the password. Please make sure that SSID is case sensitive. For example, if your SSID is book with capital B, if you type lowercase b, it will not work. So pay attention to that. And here we are from web server, we are initializing our server at port 80. This is a function that sends the temperature on the screen. This screen is coming from this function, and we create a string called page, and this is a doc type. And then the next line, page, this page we are adding to this page, which is sorted from this value, and this we are adding line by line more stuff to it. So we are concatenating, and this is the title that you see. That is this title. The refresh is coming here. Do not change anything here. And this is the text, Robojax DHT code. Which is this code. And then we check if the DHT type is equal to DHT 11. We just print the temperature as integer. Else, if it's not DHT 11, then it's DHT 22. Then we type it with one decimal point, add it to this page, and then we put the unit, which is degrees Celsius, in here. And then we have a break. This portion is for humidity. We put the title and the value for the humidity and the unit, which is a percent symbol, and that is done. And then the body and HTML is added to page. And here we use server.send 200 is an OK request. And this is a type text HTML. And the page that has all the information is sent. And this is just sending the page this line. Handle not found is a function that if you type something different on the code, you will get it. Let me show you. For example, at the end, if you type here /book, this is the answer, and this is handling it. Handle not found, and it says URL, method, argument, and then something not found will be displayed. So we are creating message and sending it as a server with 404 code as a plain text. That's why not found and /book and get an argument. So this was taking care of that. Inside the setup, we initialize that DHT with DHT.begin. This is initializing the serial monitor. This is initializing the Wi-Fi. And we are passing SSID and password. And this is just printing this new line on the screen. While Wi-Fi status is not equal Wi-Fi link connected. If it's not connected, then we have delay 500 milliseconds, and then we print this dot. So this will continue until it is connected, and this is equal false, because initially it needs some time to connect. So the number of dots shows how many seconds we have waited until it's connected. And then we have this text, and then we are printing connected to, and then we type the SSID on the screen, and then we print this text, and then at the end we print in this IP address after that, and we say to read temperature. And MDNS begin, we can also access it using Robojax DHT instead of IP address, and paste that, enter. It did not work, so let's put http://, and then DHT. As you can see, we are able to read it without even typing the address. So this is that DNS that we typed. And then this is the most important line that says server on root. When this is the request, there is nothing after forward slash, then send temperature, which was a function at the top of the code that I mentioned. And if server inline anything, if we just type inline forward slash inline, it will print this text. Let's test it. And here, let's put it forward slash inline. Here it says this works as well. So this was taking care of that line, and server on not found, it goes to this function which I just shown you, and then server.begin is initializing the server, and this will print this HTTP server started on the serial monitor. And inside the loop, we initialize server.handleClient, so this it must be inside the loop. And then we read DHT.temperature, we read degrees Celsius, and store it in a variable called temperature value, and we use DHT.humidity in a variable called DHT.humidity, which we defined it at the top of the code. These three have been defined at the top, and this is temperature F for Fahrenheit. So we call DHT read temperature true, so this will convert it to Fahrenheit. So we have three values, and if we have show serial, then it will print that temperature with a unit on the screen, this text. And then if it is DHT 11, we will type the temperature. If it is DHT 22, we print it with one decimal place, and then this prints new line, and we have 300 millisecond delay, and the loop will continue, does all these tasks over again. If you want to change, and if you don't need a humidity, this is humidity. From there to here, just remove it and it will be fine. Or if you don't need that temperature, then remove this text, keep this P, and remove up to here. So remove all of this, and if you need it, you will get just humidity. Now let's see how we can select the ESP32 board. We can click here under the select board and type here ESP32DEV. As soon as you type dev, you will see dev board. You can select it and click OK. So the board has been selected. Now we have to select the port. The other way to select the board is click on Tools, Board, ESP32, and select the ESP32 dev module. Now we have to select the port. If I click here, it shows two ports, and I don't know which one belongs to my device. Sometimes you will not see the number properly. So the best way to be sure, right click on the start menu, go to the device manager, and you will see here the ports. If I click on this arrow, it will show me the ports. One is USB serial CH340, the other is USB serial device. And here, now it's connected. If I disconnect this, one of them disappear. The one that disappeared is my board. So 6 stays and 8 disappeared. If I connect it, So it is my COM port, CH340. Now it is my COM port and I can select it. Or I can click on tool port and here you will see it. You can select whichever you want. Ours is COM 8. Now we have successfully selected the board and the port. And this is very important. It must be done first. And here is a demonstration. The Wi-Fi is connected to the same SSID as this phone. Otherwise, you will not be able to see it. And the same way your computer, should be connected to the same network as the ESP32. I'm clicking on this button to upload it. The code has been uploaded. Now I'm pressing this button now, and you will see, let's stop this, and it says that the IP address is 192.168.0.103. So this is the IP address that we are going to copy and paste. Right click, or maybe just copy. So we are going to this address, and here the IP address that I visited is 192.168.0.103, and the code is being refreshed every 3 seconds, and this is now in Fahrenheit. If we want to change it to Celsius, we could do so in here. We can change the unit here. We will make this 1 to 0. 0 means Celsius, and upload the code. Upload is completed. The IP address has not changed. And here the unit has changed to Celsius. And here I've connected my mobile phone to 192.168.0.103, and I can read that temperature here on this screen. I can put them side by side so you can see it on the same time on the mobile device and on your browser, either your PC or tablet, whatever you have, you can see that. Now let me get a heat gun. I will apply some heat. Let's see if it goes higher. So pay attention, this is every 3 seconds. And as you can see, the temperature has increased, and this one is also showing 50 degrees and 20% humidity, or 25. Now you see, one is lagging in a few seconds, so this was started at a different time. But every 3 seconds, we can get a refreshed value.